talk about the future of 5G services and impact of OSS and BSS. Yesterday we had some interesting sessions that gave us very useful insight about how our industry is moving with high-tech innovation. And the new businesses are evolving with advancement of artificial intelligence, software-defined networking, virtualization, drones, robotics, and digital transformation. What was difficult to imagine a few years ago is now suddenly within our reach. Traditional industries like transportation, healthcare are being revolutionized by artificial intelligence. The impact of social media has outgrown much beyond the normal optimistic expectations. Every day comes with the promises of more to come, and the daring dreams are rapidly turning into ordinary realities. So that means there's an entire shift in the ecosystem, and this shift is not only from technology to software, but the way we think, the way we work, and the way we focus. Before going to the subject, allow me to share a brief highlight about VivaCoin. As some of you are already aware, VivaCoin is the subsidiary of Saudi Telecom and started its operation back in 2008. In fact, recently, we celebrated our 10th year anniversary. At that time, entering in a highly saturated market where mobile penetration rates were amongst the highest, and Viva had no choice but to be innovative and dynamic. Therefore, innovation has always been an essential part of Viva DNA from day one. OSS and BSS platform in Viva has always been ahead of competitor. Another important thing I want to highlight, Viva became the first operator in the MENA region to deploy full real-time convergent billing system in 2016. And due to this 100% real-time rating and charging, Viva also attained lowest usage exposure base rate in the region as well. To stay on top of the technology wave, we've already initiated the rollout of 5G network and targeting to deploy about 1,000 sites this year, and almost 100 has already been implemented and commissioned. Moving forward, let me define a basic problem that I think that we are facing in service environment. If we think about year after year, we need to continue to add bandwidth, 50% growth every year, 50% more bandwidth, 50% more bandwidth. That's what we are used to doing that. But at the same time, our revenue is not growing from our customer at the same rate that our bandwidth is increasing. It would be a great day if our revenue also increased from our customer at the same rate our bandwidth is increasing. That means as a service provider, we have to really look ourselves in a different way. We need to find a way, we need to look at network elasticity, software-defined working, networking, virtualization, as a way to solution to offer our services to the customer rather than just sharing a bandwidth, what we used to do in the past. Let's take a look on a few statistics. I want to talk about what is going to be happen by 2020. 4.2 billion global internet users, representing 53% of global population. We need to provide a network infrastructure and systems for that. 82% of world IP traffic going to be a video. As per statistics, currently in US, it's almost 60%. It has nothing to do, but it will grow. We have to prepare for that. Another important factor that I want to highlight that the global IP traffic will reach 194 exabyte per month and 2.3 zettabytes annually. And the connected devices, 2.2 billion. It is phenomenal. How much data will flow from our network? So again, as a network provider, we have to prepare ourselves because at the end of the day, it's our network that will flow on top of. So let's see what is causing all of this growth. The explosion of IoT devices create bandwidth, but at the same time, really opportunity for us. If we think about factories are running in a whole different way, and they are using IoT as a way to automate themselves, our transportation and healthcare industries are looking in a whole different way. The point is that as soon as there's a traffic increase, there's a really opportunity for, it creates a revenue opportunity for us, revenue growth as well. We need to look in industries like transportation, healthcare, how they can, while utilizing our infrastructure, can influence and enforce the flexibility which is there in order to create a revenue opportunity as IoT as well. If we look in this way, the evolution from 3G to 4G was significant, but it is nothing as compared to the expected progress from 5G. The download speed is 1,000 times faster than 4G. Latency is 1 millisecond as compared to 100 millisecond in 4G. These are exciting features. It gives a lot of variety to offer operator to deliver a wide range of services like smart vehicles, smart cities, smart transportation, smart energy, data center, cloud-based services, drones, augmented reality, and fixed wireless, replacement of fixed wireless access. So if we see that these are very exciting services, this will change the entire user experience. We can provide services in the autonomous car, remote surgeries, augmented reality. But the point is that in order to deliver such services as an operator, we need to change our mindset 180 degrees. Because with the same mindset, because today our whole network and our systems are based on voice, data, and video. And if we see that, the significant amount of IoT devices and the ecosystem elements will come in place, it will be difficult to manage these services and deliver these services with the same system. So we have to really put our efforts to manage our system to tackle these ecosystem and the functionality which needs to be delivered by these services. So if we look into this, 5G is not a speed. It's basically a technology, it's a combination of technology, so we cannot take it like a revenue stream that what we are seeing in 3G and 4G. So we see that all the use cases, there are smart homes, smart cities, enhanced gaming, emergency services, automated industries. In order to deliver all the features and services, we need to have a comprehensive system in place, the OSS, BSS system in place, like customer care management, billing and charging, partner management, and service orchestration. Because all of these services cannot be served, the 5G services is not just like a speed which we used to in 4G. So there are extensive changes required in the OSS, BSS platform, which I will go a little bit detail in my further slides. If we see that from where the revenue is coming, all of these services which is coming, which can generate projected 5G revenue is 2026 is $1.6 trillion. And as I said, technology must be turned into services and services into revenue. Up to 72% of 5G revenue growth is dependent on transformation of operational and business support systems. Failing to modernize OSS, BSS could result into an immediate and negative impact on revenue, with up to 67% of potential revenue at risk. 63% of connectivity-related revenue for these use cases is dependent on OSS and BSS transformation. So we can see that how much potential, all this potential revenue is based on how much efficient our OSS and BSS system are.